I was not a history student, but I've been very fond of history, and I try to seek inspiration from history, be it antique watches in the past, be it antique coins of the past, be it antique stamps of the past. In fact, we have made watches using stamps also, postal stamps. Okay. That has been my source of inspiration. But the person who has been, you know, kind of guiding force behind the whole journey for me in Jaipur, he's a third generation jeweler. He's a very known numismatist personally. He's related to me also, but he's more of a guru to me. He's a numismatist. He's got the world's largest collection of Jaipur state coins across the globe. And he's a jeweler. He's very knowledgeable in terms of stone cutting. His name is Mr. Prakash Chand Kothari, and he's father-in-law of my sister. So that way he's been related to me, but he has been more of a guru to me because he's the one who has always pushed me beyond, you know, boundaries in a way. You have to make sure, Gaurav, that the quality of the product is there. You have to make sure that this watch is not for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. This watch is going to last with the customer for at least 30 to 50 years. You have to ensure the product what you make lasts for 30 to 50 years minimum. Because it is not jewelry. Jewelry and watches are different. Jewelry changes after, say, 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. But watch is something which will be passed from one generation to other generation. These are heirlooms what you have to create, and you have to ensure that you deliver the quality what you are actually building your brand for.